Hey, there we go.
How are you doing? I'm just going to kick back here in my comfy little studio chair. Every day it gets a little cleaner, a little more organized in my shop. Everywhere I go and work a little bit every day, I get something a little bit more clean. And then when I come home, I reward myself by cleaning a little bit here and a little bit there and appreciating what I did the night before or the day before. And I did some stuff yesterday. Hopefully it all worked out. And today, what am I working on today? Well, I want to start tearing some stuff apart. It's time to start thinking about kit bashing. So I have this really interesting looking puppy copter thing. It is the Paw Patrol, I think. I saw a logo on it somewhere. I thought I saw a logo on it somewhere. But I think you'll agree that with a little bit of work, you see, it's got a spot for an action figure to kind of sit already, as you can see it's right there, right? So it stands to reason that this could be kit bashed into something just a tad more realistic. So, okay, there's that big flat wall back there. I've already drawn in there with a Sharpie what I kind of want to do. Because if you turn around backwards this other way, and you look in here, you'll see that all of that detail in there, I can open that up. Okay. And there's just a handful of screws that hold this thing together. But yeah, that's what I'm going to do right now, this very second, on camera. I'm going to destroy this toy. First we destroy it, and then we see what we can turn it into. With the ashes. Everything's a rising phoenix over here in kitbasher land. But there's probably going to be lots of buttons and stuff that fall off the place. Probably going to need a regular screwdriver as well. I already know I'll need both of those. I'll get them out. Let's sit back down. Some of these you have to get in here and get them one at a time. All right, next one. I like doing it with the tool because the noise is much more, I don't know, annoying to the listener. Oh my. Well, yeah, outside of opening that cavity up a little bit there, I'm going to primer the living hell out of it. So it'll be, you know, battleship gray. Oh, there's a small one here. I bet you that's a battery compartment. That's nice. I'm not interested in hearing any noises out of this thing. I don't care what it made. I don't care what noises it made. I almost don't want to know. And I don't have those batteries, so I'm already not worried about it. Start dumping screws out. Dump this other one out. And here's one over here we gotta get out on the tail. If some poor kid's watching this, looking for this toy, going, oh, I just want one of those. I know they don't make them anymore. And sees this video. Sorry, not sorry. This is in the interest of making it look as Star Wars-y as possible. So, what we do when we're kit bashing is we take something that was and we tear it to pieces for a couple of reasons. We want to start appropriating things from it. I like the basic general shape of this. It's got kind of a flying submarine helicopter space cadet kind of thing going on. What I want to do is, I think it's interesting as a ship landed with its landing gear down and this back flap open so that you can see up into it, and then the cockpit in the same way, being able to see into that cockpit what's going on, even if it's obstructed with the blue. I plan on putting, and there's obviously power to it already. I'm going to probably do it with a 9-volt or something, but I'm going to put LEDs in this when I'm finished with it so that it has some lit detail to give it sort of, you know, show off whatever's going on inside of this canopy. Okay, there's that, there's these. Let's see, we got that screw, got that. There might be a couple of these on the bottom that need to come out. I think this is like a 3-piece shell kind of construction, is what it's starting to look like. And I don't want to lose all this stuff, so I have to be careful that I don't lose a bunch of pieces parts here. Only lost one screw so far, but like I said, I don't want to lose a bunch of stuff. I was just looking over at my Dremel, and the good news is the cutting tool that I want is already on the tool. So that's going to help things drastically move forward faster. Here. There we go. Now, there's one more. No, two more, actually. Hopefully you can't hear my cartoons in the background. I got, Okay, I'm watching Clone Wars. Hopefully the volume's not too high where I get a copyright strike or something stupid, but usually when I'm kit bashing, I'll watch any number of things on YouTube. Or I'll pop on Netflix or Disney Channel or, you know, just general YouTube stuff. And occasionally a movie of some kind, but most of the time just, you know, the YouTube. Oh, hey, there's another screw that has come out of here. Wow, this thing's pretty complicated. Oh, this other one might be biting on still. Oh, yeah, it is. Okay, I just found the logo down here on the inside. It says Paw Patrol. So that makes a lot of sense. So I thought, I don't know if it was Pound Puppies, and that didn't make sense. But, yeah, it's Paw Patrol is what this thing was. But, yeah, we're going to completely transform this. I like the idea of having some sort of a quad hopper type thing going on. I do like the airplane engines back here, but I think those are going to go on like some form of a speeder. What's going to happen with those? Can't get those out of there. Maybe I just pull this thing apart. Hey, I got the bottom of it off. All right. So, there's the bottom piece of that thing. Take those little wings off. Oop. I just lost some pieces, parts, the spring. Alright. And that's what it looks like on the inside of it. Hey, yeah, it's starting to look, you know what it's starting to look like right now? Yeah, do you see it? Does anyone else see that? Come on, Star Wars fans. Do you not see it? Do you not see what I'm seeing? Take a damn good look at that. Holy smokes. Holy smokes. Wow. Yeah, which brings into question, what is it that we're going to do with this? Oh, wow. I know you see it if you're a Star Wars fan. I know you see it. Okay? Boba Fett Slave 1 immediately. All I had to do is like maybe fashion out some sort of a skirting around it. It could happen. I don't know if that's what I'm going to do. But boy, oh boy, it's tempting. That looks really cool. Because here's what's left of it. Here's the bottom half of it. It's got this kind of apparatus going on. Wow. That just blew my mind. So this version of it, I don't think I'll go that far with it. I just want to open this thing up. The last two screws, hopefully this is the last, this will be the last two screws. And this is holding like the cockpit where the seat and part of that wall is that we were looking at. It's got the Sharpie line in it that I need to kind of cut through. And here we go. What do we got here? Checking, we get all the screws out. Yep, so it shouldn't be too fussy to pull apart. All right, we have some electronics up here though. That might be part of the problem. So yeah, I got her. Okay, there's some pieces of plastic kind of falling. We don't want to lose them, just sit right there. We're going to take a lot of this stuff out of here. There, we got our, we just lost our window. This back piece does not want to come undone. It might be sonic welded. Or just... Don't quite understand why that's so tough to get off of there. But we'll get her. Even if we have to take a little pryer in there. And spread some of that space apart. There, we're starting to get her. There, got it. Ha ha, there's the inside. And there's all that stuff. Let's take it out. Before we destroy it, let's just take it out of there. Because it's extra weight. And, it's just... Remove... what we don't need out of this thing. Okay, there we go. So, without breaking anything, I want to kind of slide some more of these parts away from one another. Ah, there we go. Alright, I just lost the part on the floor. There, okay, I'm just getting this light fixture up out of here. And we're not gonna use that. We're gonna pull this window out. And I'm obviously gonna have to get down on my hands and knees on the floor and look for a lot of these pieces, parts. Get a magnet and pick up a lot of these screws that I dropped on the floor. I didn't drop too many of them. A couple. But, you know, it's not too bad. Oh, wow, you're watching me do all that stuff and you can't really even see it. So I think some of this has maybe some sort of a weld. Oh, I just noticed that there's actually another screw. That's why it doesn't want to just slide out of there. Tell ya. Dane Bramage. There we go. Oh, that cool little blue window. All right, that's a piece. Trying to save all these little pieces to it. That's it. All these little screws. I am probably gonna lose more than half of them before this is all said and done. Luckily, I recognize the screw pattern and I know I've got a box of them. So, that's not a big deal. I can put this back here. I can bring this piece back out. And, I don't need to mess with too much of that at all. I really don't 100% understand. Oh, it's pressure fit. Not pressure fit, but smart fit. Smarter than me fit. So, taking all of this out of there. And now, look how easy it's going to be to get to all that. You know, I was going to work on some guitar stuff tonight. I do have a little bit of logo work to do tonight, which I will do before I close the night out. And I think I'm going to reach behind me and get my Dremel power from this. Right back here. Power strip here. I think I'm just gonna see how easy this is. Sandpaper and spray paint do wonders for cleanup work on this kind of a job, but I'm gonna put this thing at 15. All right, and we're just gonna get in here and I'm gonna cut that tape up out of there. First one. Mm-hmm. Kind of break that out of there. There we go. Give the Dremel a rest. Let's go in here with So that's not too bad. So now we've got that opened right up. So as you can see, just for some visual juxtapositioning, what we had happening in there were something. Oops, there we go. Right here. Something like that going on, right? But I really want to open up all of this. So, as you can see, I have a lot of thinking to do on this piece. So, I'm not just yet on that one. But, yeah, now, just imagine how that's going to open up the view into the back, which means all this has to come apart, including this other window. Primer and all that stuff has to go on there. And then I can put it back together and visualize how to detail the inside of it. So that now that we're going to see the inside of it, we'll kind of want to run some fake wires and cables and greebles and all that kind of stuff on the inside to make the inside look like something completely wacky, crazy, like it's not ever been anything else. Now, quickly. We don't have much time. And then again, after all that's done, we'll go through and weather. Weathering is basically after you've made it look perfect and brand new, you throw some black and brown umbery kind of colors and some mustards and other shit in there. And make things look like they got wet and rusted at one point or another. The more used it starts to look on the inside, the more it fits into that Star Wars universe. And the more realistic it looks, the more used it looks. And then if you weather your action figures the same way, a lot of them actually come in fairly decently weathered, where they don't look like a toy. They look really realistic. And that's pretty cool, but yet some of them still need a little bit of help. Like a lot of you are looking at this video going, that guy right there needs a little help. All right, so look at this cool little engine we've got. I mean, that's, you could, you know, I'm a fan of things being in pairs, so I like the right wing, left wing airplane look with a pilot in the middle. That's my favorite kind of design. So I'm kind of saving those engines for that purpose. I think they're going to become something else. Actually, I know they're going to become something else. There we go. Yeah, there we go. Now, there's this whole... What is that? Another thing that I don't really know what it is or why. Interesting. Check it out. There we go. So, okay, so that's the one we just took apart. I'm going to get this other collary thing off of here, too. Whatever this thing was and whatever all this is for no longer applies to what it is now and what it's going to become, because this big handle piece is probably going to come off of there. I think I'm going to take all that off of there, flatten that out somehow, maybe droid cockpit up there. Yeah, there's this area here. I don't know. Or, yeah, most likely a gun turret or something up there. Hey, it says R2 on the inside of there. It's wild. It's to say on this one. This one says R2 and this one says L2. Haha, so I'm gonna do a red and yellow and white R2-D2 at some point. R2-L2. I'll name him R2-L2 after this helicopter. But maybe I'll station him inside of this helicopter when I'm done. Or better yet, I'll make one. I'll make an R2 and name him L2-R2. I'll use red, yellow, and white plastic to make him. And then he'll match what this originally was in his paint scheme. And that'll be cool. And then it'll be like a secret Easter egg. Okay, so doesn't that look interesting and different? What used to be crazy helicopter is 25 minutes of tearing it apart. We're close to maybe putting some of it back together. But hey, just because we got the Dremel out here doesn't mean we can't do all this right now. Of course we can. Alrighty. Same thing. There. Exacto knife. Go in there and just kind of clean up that edge a little bit. There we go. Okay, so now I can put that back together. And now when you look up into the inside of this back here, you see further back into this apparatus. So as I put it on here, do you see where I'm going with this? So you literally can see all the way into the front of this to over here, okay? Because the deck, I don't have the deck on there yet. So I'm gonna sit that there for a minute. It holds itself together. And let's see. I have to at least remove a good chunk of this. I'm gonna open this up first. I want to open that up. So how am I going to do that? I'm not 100% sure. But it's got to happen. So let's start by seeing where we can make a cut. And if we can make that cut. It's going to be difficult. It's going to be very difficult. It's gonna be tricky. Very, very tricky. But I'm going to say we got a cut in here. I just know, right, that in order for that to make sense to pass through into what's up there, this all just needs to pass through. If there's empty space under it, because there's empty space in the middle of that, we'll deal with it. The side pieces are going to remain somewhat intact, and it'll be fine. It's fine. I'm fine. Everything's fine. Alrighty. Plastic. I tell you what, if I'd have had a date, if I would have had a Dremel when I was a kid, oh, what a dangerous tool that would have been. There wouldn't have been any safe action figures. No, no way. I'd have cut them all into little itchy bitsy pieces, all of them. Wouldn't have been able to help myself. Not if I had a Dremel at my disposal. So we made a lot of important cuts in here. A lot of this is going to be sacrificial because we can't really save it. And let's see how much of this we can actually free up by cutting free from corner to corner. Try not to stab myself in an important area. I'll show you what I've got so far. I've got those cuts made almost all the way to the corners. And then those cuts made. But as you can see, I'm gonna have to free some of the stuff up, mainly in the corners. So I'm gonna have to dip back into the toy box behind me for a little hobby box knife. Hopefully I can get in there with this one. Otherwise, I might have to do a little thinking as to where my other hobby knife is. All right, yeah, I should be able to get in here with that. Nope. Oh, I can get in here with this one, though. Aha! This little box knife is perfect for that cut. And of course, once I get all that freed up and opened, I will be able to get in there. Might be able to get in there. Oh, hey, wait. I can get to this from the back side as well. So, I'm gonna do this. Getting a lot of it out of there. Taking into consideration the part that I want to salvage versus the part that I don't. Break those corners free. All right. There. Had to twist that piece to get it off of there. Now I've got a lot of that out of there. It's going to be a matter of cleaning up now. I'll take this in here and clean up around the edges. And then we take this guy right here. This guy's really good for cleaning up all the burrs really quickly. Thank you. And there it is. Now the rest of it I can clean up with the X-Acto knife. And the rest will be basically sandpaper and mini file. This little bugger. It takes a little while. You're doing real time here watching this. Hopefully by this point I've fast forwarded through a lot of this bullshit, but I'm just cleaning up some of the buggers out of here. There we go. And I get rid of all my tool marks. It'll look more like it was meant to be, like this. There we go. That's pretty good for now. Now, looks a little more like it was meant to be. So, let me pop this guy apart again. Let's take it back to our 3D. And get some perspective as to what it is that we just did to this poor toy. Let's put you back where you belong. Okay, and we might as well slide the cockpit up over here. And now, slide this guy back on here. Might be missing a couple pieces parts, but that's okay. For the most part, we got most everything back where it needs to be. Okay, so we have that. Let's go ahead and open that up. Now you can see further back into the rest of it back here. So that doesn't really look, doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Well, I guess it does. Let's put a dude in there just to make it make sense here. Here, we'll call him Pilot Dude. Hey there, Pilot Dude. That gives you an idea as to perspective. As to, he's maybe a little taller. He's maybe 4 inches or more, as opposed to a 3 3/4 action figure. But there's the bottom. When I put the bottom back on this, now that the hatch is open the way it is. Now, mind you, we haven't primered this or added or subtracted more or less from it to make it more spaceship-y. I just wanted to impress upon you what it looks like now when it's, landed. And you have this cockpit area that looks, you can see all the way down and through it. And you can see this landing area, all that. And especially from the back side of it, where you can look in there and you can see that pilot sitting there, and you can see how like a droid could roll itself all the way up in there and find himself next to the pilot, or maybe his luggage, or you know, whatever. It's a little bit cramped space in there, but hey, doesn't have to necessarily have to make perfect sense for it to make enough sense for it to work. But I think I can probably open that up a little bit more and make it more of an angle, which I probably will before I'm all done with this. But that's stage one of where we're going with this. Now you can see that there's all this square cutout back in here. I'm envisioning something much more in the market of something like that back here as a pair of wings or engines, I'm sorry. And then maybe the engines being longer, say like the length of this or more. Wider and more bulkier like that. So, you know, 1, 2, 3, 4. And maybe they're not identical. Maybe they're all just similar but different in different ways. Obviously, one's going to be painted different. 3 of them will look like they belong on there, and 1 of them will look like it came from some other ship from 2 years prior or something, or whatever the case may be. That's how Star Wars is. There's always one fucked up looking part. If Star Wars had a Chevy, one door would be red, the rest of it would be primer gray, with hoses and wires sticking out everywhere, and a droid sticking out the trunk. You know, Star Wars. It's all fucked up like that. So, this is a long-ass video, and just tearing apart this little dude, and doing that little bit of Dremeling, but if you look at the very back beginning of this video, before I did that, there's all this stuff in there blocking, so you could not see into the back. So we are already about 10% our way into our kit bashing of this thing. A lot of this cockpit fuselage area inside of here, a lot of it can remain as is at this point. It's just going to be paint apps and wire, and then maybe finding a way to poke some lighting in. I'm thinking up here on this underside here, there's enough girth in this handle area to be able to put some sort of stuff like that. Oh, and there's this little round thing where there used to be a speaker. Something's telling me, oh man, that just makes me feel like it should be an R2 unit, but no, I don't know. Turret. I think gun turret, that's what that's going to be. What can we do to the rest of this? Do you think we should cut the top off just yet? I don't know. I'm starting to feel like maybe this should come off. I don't know. Could be risky. There's no going back once I do it. But It would look cool without it. 50 minutes? Fuck it. Let's do it. Commitment. Sometimes that's what life is all about. Alrighty. Might as well do the other side now. Our pilot bailed on us, by the way. He could take no more. He dove out onto the floor. Smobook. I have a snubble smobook. Pop that back off. Pop one of these sides off in here. Boy, once this side gets put back together back here, it doesn't want to come apart. There we go. I may put a little Vaseline on these joints so that they come apart better in the next few applications here, because I know if I keep doing this, I'm gonna break this thing somehow or another. Okay. All right, so we can take our thing. Now that we can see our seams. Just like that, we got the handle piece off of there. There we go. All right. So what we'll do is we'll kind of just really quickly clean some of that off of there so it doesn't look so terrible. Let the Dremel cool off for a second. And you know we're going to hit this with the sander in a second anyway. Oh, I'm just going in here, getting these hard edges off. There it is. There, look at all that. Looks a lot cleaner, doesn't have all that buggery stuff hanging off of it. All right, we sit him over here. What's the next piece? I gotta go through the same thing. Finish cutting where the other one let where I couldn't get into all those spots. Now I can see it just fine. There, I got most of that cut. And I got just one little part to bite through in the middle here. Like right here. There we go. We can put some of this back together. So it kind of has some interesting detail once it's taken out of context. You know, it's not a terrible detail. Yeah, could be a number of things. Anything can become anything. It's a whistle. So now, we're getting even further away from what we had before. Now we have this kind of a detail on the top with all that. So, although I did kind of destroy the Boba Fett-esque look that we had going on, but I'm more interested in having a flat top on this. Yeah, that's what we use this guy for. There, I cleaned it up. Wow, it was an hour 25 minute video on me playing with this dumb thing. I'm obviously gonna have to speed that up, double time it to make it, not the most boring video in the world. But let's see here. So, we already know there's a little thing called putty. We're going to be utilizing that. I can't really get in there and cut that out of there the way I want to. It's going to have to be probably sanded out. And that's that little corner piece right there. I just kind of really want to somehow saw that off of there. This little flush cut saw is the shizzle. Really hard to get to area in here, but now that I've got it out of there, whoo, feels a lot better. So yeah, I'm probably gonna end up gluing it the opposite way. I'm just looking to see how much of what I cut out of there can be reused. And then I think with a little bit of glue, I can reuse this piece. Let's check this out. I don't know if you can see that in there. That piece. No, you can't now. So anyway, I opened that up a little bit there. So now there's not such a little chunk of stuff on this corner. And of course, I'm gonna fill all that negative space in so that it will be just, it'll be flat. So it'll essentially be a continuation, and I'm gonna pull that little nodule of stuff off of there. Well, we'll leave it on there for the moment. But anyway, we accomplished that. I'm just gonna leave this guy in pieces over here for now. Until next time, buddy, we'll see ya. Enjoy it. This one, I'm gonna fill the back of that with wires and all kinds of technical looking stuff. And it's gonna be kind of hanging from the wall in my Jawa sandcrawler. So this is as if this is what Jawas use to tear shit apart and melt stuff down with. That's what's gonna happen inside of my sandcrawler. That's what I'm saving him for. So, and this one, hopefully, is just big enough maybe to sit just inside the sand crawler. That's how big my sand crawler will be. All right, it's an hour and 6 minutes and counting. I'm gonna call it a good video. I got a graphic design project I gotta work on, so I'm gonna do that, and then I'm gonna turn in. We'll see you next time.